The Anti-Red Tape Authority, together with the Department of Information and Communications Technology, launched the National Business One-Stop Shop, or NBOS, Friday, a physical location wherein an entrepreneur can register and apply for licenses and permits with the Securities and Exchange Commission, the Department of Trade and Industry, the Bureau of Internal Revenue, the Social Security System, PhilHealth, and Pag-ibig, all at the same time. Through data sharing and streamlined queuing and payment, these NBOS sites will cut the process of starting a business in the Philippines from 13 steps in 33 days to 9 steps in 7.5 days. Information and Communications Technology Secretary Gringo Nasan says the streamlined government transactions would put the onus on entrepreneurs to prove they are trustworthy and eliminate any opportunity for the corrupt practice of paying for permits and licenses.
We trust you until proven otherwise. Ang laking bagay nito sa pagbabawas ng bila. A shorter, streamlined process will lessen the chances of dishonest practices.
The DICT is also working on the Central Business Portal, the online platform which will complement NBOS and achieve the goal of allowing all private sector transactions with government to be done on mobile phones. The first phase of CBP was launched in October 2019, but it has not yet been formally launched. Trade Secretary Ramon Lopez says it is close.
So DTI, we've also started our own small digitalization. Kasi po yung business name registration, we were able to put it online as well, up to the payment. And we are able to do it now in 8 minutes. We're even talking of less than 1 hour or less than 30 minutes, no? In this starting a business. And we are all very passionate and excited. Ang nakikita ko po dito, we're getting near that less than 1 hour na online application.
Jeremiah Belgica, Director General of ARTA, says the work is moving forward and he is very hopeful it will result in real change. However, ARTA needs the help of all agencies and government offices. This includes the streamlining and automation of each of their own processes and transactions.
You cannot interconnect a system that is not streamlined. You know, you put all of those unnecessary requirements and necessary procedures and then you automate it. What's going to happen? It might crash.
Belica adds, this is only addressing starting a business. There are other permits and licenses which need to go through multiple agencies and tens, even hundreds of signatories, which need to be streamlined. And this would require the aid of the Interior and Local Government Department.
Kada LGU ay meron silang creative way of coming up with a system and requirements. That's the reason why Administrative Order number 23 issued by the President, signed February 21 and issued yesterday, is very, very critical.
Administrative Order 23, signed by President Rodrigo Duterte, enjoins all of government to comply with the anti-red tape laws and hasten their own reforms to eliminate overregulation and make it easier for the private sector to work with government in obtaining permits, approvals, and other documents or face administrative cases. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.